This is Mission Control Houston. The Expedition 34 crew has had a busy Thursday taking care of their home on orbit while participating in a range of research activities that are designed to learn more about how people can live in an environment that is absent of gravity. After rebooting the computers in the Kibo laboratory and performing maintenance at the waste hygiene compartment, Station Commander Kevin Ford set up a camera in the lab to record the day's activities of the Robonaut. That's a test bed for developing new robotics capabilities in space. It's hoped that the testing with Robonaut 2, as you see here, will lead to machines that can assist with work tasks and actually interact with human crew members. After working with flight engineer Tom Marshburn to replace some piping in the waste hygiene compartment, Ford returned to the lab to power down and disassemble the Robonaut until its next experiment operations. Flight engineers Oleg Novitsky, Yevgeny Tarelkin, and Roman Romanenko kicked off their day with two public affairs interviews, and then Novitsky and Tarelkin moved on to shooting scenes for a documentary about life on board the International Space Station. Roman Romanenko left them there to complete his first exercise session of the day using the advanced resistive exercise device, and then moved on to some routine maintenance, some filter cleaning inside the Rosviet module of the space station. After lunch, Romanenko joined Tarelkin to work on the documentary about life in space, while Novitsky continued his work installing new wall panels in the Zvezda module. For flight engineers Chris Hadfield and Tom Marshburn, their day began working together to set up the MARES experiment hardware. The Muscle Atrophy Research and Exercise System is a European Space Agency project in human research and countermeasures development that is just getting its first tryout on board the space station, being set up for its first use. Exercise using that facility is designed to provide researchers with some better understanding about how living in zero gravity affects the human muscular system, and therefore to evaluate just how well the existing countermeasure systems on board the space station are working to help prevent the decline of the muscular system. They, Hadfield and Marshburn, will keep working with the ground teams on Friday to troubleshoot an issue that they encountered during the setup today when the MARES rack shut down as soon as they began charging the batteries. Hadfield later and Marshburn together had more time set aside for orientation for new crew members. That's a standard line item in a day's agenda for crew members who have just been at the space station for a couple of weeks. After lunch, Tom Marshburn went to help Commander Kevin Ford with some maintenance work in the Tranquility module, where they replaced some piping at the waste hygiene compartment. Chris Hadfield was then sent on to retrieve some detectors for the Radian bubble detector experiment. That's a Canadian experiment to characterize neutron radiation in the environment of the space station. After that, he was to get started in the Destiny laboratory with a partial removal of the station's agricultural camera from the Windows Observational Research Facility. The agricultural camera, known as Isaac, that project is complete. The plans are that once Isaac is removed from the wharf, the window will be inspected next week, and then a new environmental research and visualization system will be installed in its place. The iSERV, as it's known, is an automated system to acquire imagery, but it's designed mostly to gain experience in automated data acquisition on the station. In the process, it will also acquire useful imagery for disaster monitoring and for environmental decision making. The station crew members are looking ahead to wrap up this short work week with the troubleshooting and hopefully functional testing of the MARES experiment on Friday as well as more science operations throughout the station, and another ground commanded by students competition using the Spheres satellites.